Good morning, Unity Atlanta.
Good morning.
Just want to say welcome to everybody who's here in person today, and as well as those of you on the stream. Got some great stuff ahead for you. Next, we've got Beautiful Day by Jamie Grace. Please enjoy.
Wake up and smile,
Cause it's been a while. It's been like a whole day since you stopped so you could hold me. This child awaits, strong in the faith. Lord, you are the refuge that I can't wait to get to. Cause I can let a day go, and let a day go by without thanking you for the joy that you bring to my life. And ooh, there's something about the way your sun shines on my face. It's a love so true I can never get enough of you. This feeling can't be wrong. I'm about to get my worship on. Take me away. It's a beautiful day. Yeah, 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 yeah. It's a beautiful day. Yeah, 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 yeah. Trouble seems to rain on my dreams. It's not a big deal. Let it wash all the bugs off my windshield. You're showing me that you I'm free. And you're still the refuge that I've just got to get to. So I won't let a day go, won't let a day go by. Put the drop top down, turn it up, then I'm ready to fly. Ooh, there's something about the way your love stands on my face. It's a love so true I can never get enough of you. This feeling can't be wrong. I'm about to get my worship on. Take me away. It's a beautiful day. Yeah, 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 yeah. It's a beautiful day.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
I've got no need for worry. I've got no room for doubt. No matter what's coming at me, you'll always be the beautiful I sing about. There ain't no limitations to your amazing grace. Your amazing grace. And there's something about the way your love shines on my face. Oh no, I can never get enough of you. This feeling can't be wrong. Gotta get my worship on. Gotta sing a brand new song. Gotta get my worship on. Take me away on this beautiful day.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah,
it's a beautiful day.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Such a beautiful day.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Such a beautiful day.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Such a beautiful day.
Thank you, Simon Needle and the Tower of Higher Power Band. It is a beautiful day. Happy Sunday. Good morning and namaste.
Namaste.
The spirit in me truly welcomes, honors, embraces, and rejoices in the spirit in you, whether you are fully present here in the Unity Atlanta Sanctuary or you are tuning in via live stream. Know that we embrace you and hold you as part of our divine and beloved community. And let us begin this Sunday morning, our fall faith journey that starts today, as we do all things with prayer. Today we affirm the power and the presence of God, divine creator of all things, which created us in love and continues to love us into being. Today we open ourselves more fully to experience this awesome power and presence in our lives as we discover new ways to engage in the world. Today we choose to meet this world, however it may appear, as our highest self, our greatest self, our best self, for this is the presence of God within us all. Today we declare our authority over our lives and know that we are richly blessed in infinite ways. For this and so much more, we are truly grateful. And let us say, thank you, God. Would you say that with me? Thank you, God. Amen. Amen. And so we are so delighted that we are able to be physically distanced back in the sanctuary and welcome some friends, old and new, back in with us. And as always, wherever you're tuning in from, we are so grateful to have you with us, with the beloved community of Unity Atlanta. We say that we're a positive, practical path for spiritual living, and our goal is always not only to affirm our faith, but to live our faith. And we're delighted that you've joined us to begin following the way of Spirit, our fall faith journey that starts today. And as always, it takes a beloved community to have a beloved community, and I'm so delighted to welcome back to the pulpit, joining me as worship partner this Sunday, a future Unity minister, Justine Lawrence. Here she is. Give her a warm, warm greeting. Namaste.
Good morning. Let's read our statement of faith together. There is only one presence and one power in the universe and in our lives, God, the good omnipotence. The daily word for today is taken from November 1963. The daily word for today is free. The affirmation is, I am spirit, I am free, unfettered, unbound. The scripture is from John chapter 8, verse 32. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. The reading says, if we feel trapped by circumstances, it is because we have forgotten our true nature, our true heritage. We may believe that we are bound, but the truth is that we have power in us to assert and to claim our freedom at any moment. Remind yourself that you are a spiritual being, a child of God, that God's Spirit is in you. There is a triumphant, transcendent, splendid spirit in you that cannot be bound, that is never limited by circumstances. This spirit is God's Spirit in you. Do not be afraid to declare your freedom in spirit. Be bold and daring in your proclamation. In faith, declare, I am spirit. I am free, unfettered, unbound. There are powers inherent in you that are mighty to renew you, to change you, to transform you and the conditions of your life. Right now, you have the mighty power of spirit within you. Right now, this spirit is working in and through you to set you free from old ways and old thoughts. Right now, this transcendent spirit in you can come forth. Again, the daily word for today is free. And the affirmation is, I am spirit. I am free, unfettered, unbound. Namaste. Now, let's prepare our hearts and our minds for meditation.
Our Father,
which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Not in temptation, but deliver us from error. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory
the kingdom and the power and the presence of God right here and right now as we move into this sacred time of guided meditation, as we become comfortable wherever we are, as we are, gently closing our eyes or gazing softly on a gentle view. We allow ourselves to make way for that power and presence of God flowing in, around, and through us now and always. We breathe in deeply that daily word affirmation that we are spirit. Free, unfettered, and unbound. Breathing in deeply that divine breath into any part of ourselves, in body, mind, or in spirit, that feels constrained, that feels constricted, that does not yet fully feel free. In that presence of God. As we breathe deeply, as we feel that breath flowing in us, we remember that we are a divine presence of God, that presence of spirit that longs to express itself in us, through us, as us. As we breathe in that presence of life, we feel the possibilities awakening within us the possibilities, the potential, the presence that is ready to come forth as the Spirit of God and live as us. We flow in this presence, and we allow it to make its way forward as we rest now for a few minutes in the silence. We are free. We are free in the Spirit to be our greatest, our highest, our best self. We are free to change our minds. We are free to change our lives, to make them more vibrant, to make them richer, to make them more wondrous, to make them an expression of that one power and that one presence we know and affirm as God the good always and in all ways. We are free in the Spirit, and we are ready to move ahead. We know this, we claim this, we affirm this for ourselves and for one another. And we are truly grateful. Amen.
Everything beneath the sun breathes like a harmonium. Your perfection has begun, shining like a midnight sun. Out of darkness I have come. I see God in every. Let me be an instrument guided by an heaven sent. May these grapes of pain ferment, alchemized to love's content, ever be a sacrament, knowing God is my end. Let me know your name. Hold me in the same breath as your word. God, I feel you all around. Oh, how you astound me with your grace. Let me know your name. Hold me in the same breath as your word. God, I feel you all around. Oh, how you astound me with your grace. Turning like a prayer field, turning like Ezekiel's wheels, breathing like a kiss seals the spirit I've become. Knowing what I'm here for, rowing on to distant shores, flowing from the infinite God in it. God, let me know your name. Hold me to the same breath as your word. God, I feel you all around. Oh, how you astound me with your grace.
out of darkness I have come. I see God in everyone.
An inspirational teaching from H. Emily Cady, a holistic healer, an inspirational new thought teacher and writer, from her book, Lessons in Truth, first published in 1895, from the chapter titled Definition of Terms. God has need of you, through whom, in some special manner, it manifests itself, some manner for which it cannot use any other means. However humble your place in life, however unknown to the world you may be, however small your capabilities may seem at present to you, you are just as much a necessity to God in its efforts to get itself into visibility as is the most brilliant intellect, the most thoroughly cultured person in the world. Remember this always and act from the highest within you.
So even before I got to Unity Seminary, there was a booklet that was going around. It used to get updated and changed, and it got passed from student to student to student. And part of the reason was that it was filled with all kinds of definitions of terms that we all had to know if we were going to go through that thing that we in code language called the LNO, which was the licensing and ordination examinations that we had to go through to make sure that we had fully worked ourselves over enough to be declared that we could be ministers. And in all these various definitions, there was stuff about the Bible and stuff about history and all kinds of metaphysical stuff. And then, of course, because this is the person that many of us choose to call a way shower, our way shower, Jesus, there were several things that we needed to know about Jesus. And so there were all these definitions, and there was Jesus of Nazareth, there was Jesus the Christ, and then there was Christ Jesus. And, you know, we'd better be all over it, not just a little, because at any moment, you know, we were all going to have to explain what that meant. And not all of us, as some of us now, had grown up in Unity. And so to actually say those words, Christ, you know, sometimes we get stuck in our mouth, or, you know, we couldn't even say it, or it was just too much because it got made into this grandiose thing in certain ways that we could never quite get to. And with the definition of Christ Jesus was the scripture that comes from Philippians, the older language that says, "Let the same mind be in you which was in Christ Jesus." You know, and we all have to kind of sit there and think about that, because, you know, we like to do practical spirituality and we like to do metaphysics. I'm like, yeah, okay. But if we were going to put that into a more modern language, it would say you must have the same attitude that Christ Jesus had. Well, you know, some of us are just like, oh, everybody pull your shoulders back, sit up straight. You know, have the same attitude that Christ Jesus had. Now, here's the thing about the definition. Christ Jesus is the ascended man. the one who is resurrected. And what that means to us, what that means for our lives, is that we, if we are to have the same mind, can also have a resurrected spirit. That we can take on the attitude of one, mystically, metaphysically, in whatever might at this moment be going on in our lives, and imagine that we could lift ourselves up somehow, as the Daily Word said, make ourselves free and unfettered. And that, beloved community, is how H. Emily Cady begins the teachings of Lessons in Truth. That we are to have in us the same mind as Christ Jesus, as this ascended master. And it's a reminder that Christ wasn't Jesus' last name. Y'all know that. I know, it's like the running joke. Wasn't his last name. But that Christ comes from Christos, meaning the anointed one, and from that ancient culture, it meant that we could have, any of us, an anointed spirit that could fully be and express that presence of God. That is how Emily Cady begins Lessons in Truth, which is our fall faith journey study that we're working as we're following the way of spirit. I know, we're all following all kinds of stuff. We can't keep up with how much stuff there is to follow. But we're invited today for this fall journey to follow the way of spirit. Put that first before all that other stuff. Because what we want to aspire to as truth students, as we study Lessons in Truth, is that we take on that attitude that Christ Jesus had, that elevated, broad, open, resurrected mindset. And it's interesting that people who work with Lessons in Truth, or people who work with a lot of the New Thought teachings, will call themselves truth students. Myrtle Fillmore, to her very last day, called herself a truth student. It means we're still learning something. That this isn't it, I'm just stuck here and this is it and I don't have anything else and I'm never going to read another book and I'm never going to listen to another song and I'm never going to do anything else. It means we're keeping open to what way Spirit might be guiding us. And so if you're tuning in, if you're here with me this morning, then I'm holding with you that something in you, for whatever reason, has called you forward in spirit to resurrect, to rise up, to shift what is happening in your life. And Emily Cady says that this is inevitable. She says sometime, somewhere, every human being must come to themselves. What does it mean to come to ourselves? It means to realize that we have a spirit in us that is as rich and wondrous as the man who was called Jesus. The thing that's cool about Jesus, as far as lots of scholars are concerned and spiritual teachers and leaders and ministers, and Jesus had the most awesome God consciousness. He had the most awesome God consciousness. He didn't do anything without God. That was what made him an awesome way shower. He wasn't trying to be God. He was trying to get the people of their time to live from their highest, their greatest, their best, in circumstances for a lot of them, even if we only know this much of the Gospels, was less than ideal. And Emily Cady is trying to do the same for us. And let me just give you a drop of context on Emily Cady. Because there'll be people like, oh, I read that, you know, 1895, so old, so passé, you know, really, get me something modern. Emily Cady was one of the first women physicians in the United States. She went to study homeopathy. Now, if you know anything about homeopathy, if you've used it as a complementary medicine, it works from the inside out, meaning that we have to work within us to bring about that healing that we want. It's different than going to the doctor and passively saying, well, just make me feel better, you know, give me the pill. Because it means we might have to work through a process of letting whatever is uncomfortable for us leaving our body. She became a physician in the 1880s before she even had the right to vote. But she was already stepping out in faith to make a difference in people's lives, to remind them that within them was a spirit that they could bring forth. The other thing that's very interesting about these teachings is that she started to write them one by one by one in the early 1890s, and I think it's that Sunday where I'm supposed to, you know, share that RevGen fact that, you know, y'all weren't here, so maybe you didn't hear. You know, the fun fact about me was that I studied AP US history and got college credit for it. So you might remember, I'll remind you, about the 1890s, that there was a Great Depression going on and a political campaign, and people were struggling to find their way. It was actually a worldwide depression. And Emily Cady went back to the teachings. She went back to the truth and began to write out these lessons for us that begin with, put on the same attitude as Christ Jesus. As your highest, as your best, as your anointed self. That's the beginning of how it begins. And the thing that she wants us to understand is that the Christ of us is our guiding spirit. It is our key to freedom. If whenever you have a moment, you want to go online or go into the bookstore after the service or get your copy off the shelf if you already have one and look at that opening chapter, she asks the question, are you in bondage or are you free? Now, maybe there were constraints. Maybe we have constraints in our lives right now. You know, in general, I know few people who don't have something that's making them feel a little tight. There are people looking for work. There are people who've been sick. There are people who are healing. There are people who have lost loved ones. And pretty much we can let that be the thing that keeps us in that proverbial, as she calls it, it's her word, bondage. Or we can be led by that Christ Spirit that is within us. And so I was very intentional. Some of you know me. You're like, oh, I know Rev Jen's got something in here. That the word for the title was Claim Your Spiritual Self. Because claim, the word claim comes from a Latin word that means to declare as truth. That when we claim something, we are declaring the truth. And so we want to claim that we are our highest, our greatest, and our best. We want to claim that we are free to move through whatever is going on, putting on that attitude that we imagine is the highest and the best attitude. And so if there were any message that any of y'all got before this moment about, you know, you can't be all that much, or you can't say the Christ, you can't even put yourself in the same category as Jesus, I'm inviting you to get right in. Get right in that category, because we know in the teachings that Jesus said all these things and greater will you do, that we are continually encouraged to live from that space. But we have to claim it. We have to claim it for ourselves, that this is the truth of who we are. And you know, it's easy with all the following that we're doing, and there's feeds and there's posts and there's stuff, and you know, there's that part of us that is less than the Christ. You know, I don't know how it is in your life. I'll just tell you about me for a second. You know, when that person I call like Reverend Snark comes out, and I'm like, oh, look at that. Do you believe they said that? Ugh. How would they think that? How could they do that? But the truth is that that's not the highest and the best. We have those thoughts, but we can lift them up and say, well, this is also a child of God. This is also a person who's working to express themselves, and I can still respond from the place that is the highest and the best in me. And if we're following the way of Spirit, then their opinion's not constraining us. They're not the one who's holding us back. When we talk about being free, we are free to decide how we will show up. And then I don't want to show up like Reverend Snark. And I don't think you want to show up as a snark either. There's another reason to pull ourselves every day into that presence. Emily Cady says to us, the Christ self not only produces an admiration or recognition or a sense of our inherent possibilities, but that when we realize that we are in the midst of a Christ expression, it actually calls us forward. It calls us out to be the Christ as well. It's a meaning of saying namaste, or why we say in some circles, the Christ in me beholds the Christ in you. Because there is something of spirit that calls us forward, that calls us into expression, to claim our spiritual self and live from that place. I would love to tell you that it is easy, some days more so than others. But it is part of working these lessons in truth so that we can continue to unfold in our greatest expression of God. And so, note takers, get ready, because this is a fall faith journey and this is our practical spirituality. And so here's something that we want you to try. Please try this at home. Not like those crazy car commercials. Let this be something that is part of your practice this week. See how easy this one is for you. Write your name, but first write Christ, and then put your name after it. What would it be like to be Christ Corey, or Christ Anne, or Christ Desiree, or Christ Jen? Look at what that says, and then consider, what is the behavior, what is the attitude that presence, that person, that highest and best would express? Because if we are studying truth, then we get to ask ourselves, how is what I'm choosing keeping me bound and fettered and constrained? Or how is this letting me be free in the Spirit? The choice, as we take this journey, as always, is ours. I behold the Christ in you, and I love you. Namaste.
Namaste.
Thank you so much, Reverend Jen. Thank you for that amazing message about how to claim freedom and our true spiritual self through being led by the Christ Spirit. Thank you. So now I'm going to indulge you with a few wonderful announcements. As always, please check the calendar on the website, unityatl.org, and please check the Facebook page so that you can stay up to date with all of the wonderful things that we have going on here. So beginning this week, we have spirit groups starting back up. They will be through Zoom. They start tonight at 5 p.m. And there's also a session on Mondays starting at 7 p.m. The topic is the Unity Classic, Lessons in Truth by Emily Cady. And I must say, there is nothing like these spiritual groups. You have the opportunity to connect with others and bounce ideas off of others who desire to grow spiritually just like you. So they are very, very rewarding. Now, are there things that you want to know about Reverend Jen? Are there things that you would like Reverend Jen to know about you? Well, the Spiritual Cafe will be this Tuesday at noon, and it's a time to converse and connect with Reverend Jen. It's an amazing time. You can sign up online at unityatl.org, and it will also be via Zoom. And finally, this Wednesday at 7 p.m., we'll have our Fall Equinox Sound Healing Service. It'll be with Reverend Jen and Gabriel Nelson Sears. These services are really wonderful, wonderful, very healing. It will be both by live stream and in person. Now, if you decide to come in person, you must register online at unityatl.org. Again, if you decide to come in person due to the pandemic, please register online. And now it's time to prepare our offering. Mother Teresa says, it's not about how much you give, but about how much love you put into giving. So don't wait until you have a great amount to give. Give what you have, and know that Unity Atlanta will take that and use it to continue to grow the spiritual community and to continue to love our community. You can give through Venmo, Cash App. Those details were displayed. And now it's time for our offering affirmation. So take your offering, put it close to your heart, and let's say this with great love. Divine love through me blesses and increases all that I give, all that I receive, and all that I have. I give in love because I am love, and I love to give. Thank you, God. Amen.
Filling me up, come the Holy Spirit, filling me up to the top of my soul. Filling me up, come the Holy Spirit, filling me up now and take control. Filling me up, come the Holy Spirit, filling me up to the top of my soul. Filling me up, come the Holy Spirit, filling me up now and take control.
Filling me up, Holy Spirit, come. Filling me up, Holy Spirit, come.
So many things try to fill me up.
Filling me up, Holy Spirit, come.
So many things try to weigh me down.
Filling me up, come, the Holy Spirit, come.
Filling my heart now until you stay.
Filling me up, Holy Spirit, come.
And chase the other things away.
Filling my heart, come Spirit,
filling me up, come the Holy Spirit, filling me up to the top of my soul. Filling me up, come the Holy Spirit, filling me up now and take control.
Filling me up, Holy Spirit, oh.
Now my heart is an open door. Here your Spirit is welcome, Lord.
Holy Spirit, come.
Fill in my heart now and let it grow.
Spirit, come.
And change my life so all will know.
Fill in
my heart, come Spirit,
come. Holy Spirit, fill me up to the top of my soul.
Now come, Holy Spirit.
control. Filling me up from the Holy Spirit. Filling me up from the top of my soul. Filling me up from the Holy Spirit. Filling me up now and take control. Filling me up now and take control.
Filling my heart, Holy Spirit.
Filling me up, filling me up.
We feel filled with the Holy Spirit. We are so grateful for all the gifts in our beloved community. We are so grateful for all the streams that flow through Unity Atlanta and all of those who give to make the Spirit shine forth, not only in ourselves, but in others too. We are so grateful to have with us so many who shine that light of Spirit. And we, every week, have an affirmation. We have affirmations that we're working specifically for this fall faith journey. And we post these on our social media on Monday so that you can put these on your feed, you can share them with somebody so that you can remember every day. Sometimes, you know, we maybe need it a couple times a day, those truth teachings that help us feel free in the Spirit. So let's affirm our first fall faith affirmation. I recognize the presence of God within me, my best self, and I choose to live every day in this awareness. You know, it would not be possible, as I said at the beginning, to have a beloved community without a beloved community. So I want to say thank you to Justine for being the worship partner, to Wes Scott, Corey, Linda, Marilyn, Pam, Lachey behind the scenes, to our Tower of Higher Power band, John, Johnny, Cam, Simon, to Rob and Robin and Corey and Anne, who brought us beautiful music, to Elizabeth, who makes sure this building is pristine and ready for us every time we can come into it. And we are so grateful for so many blessings in our lives. And now let us conclude our service with the prayer for protection.
And thank you all for being here. And to those online, thank you, thank you, thank you. We definitely feel your energy and your love. And now for our prayer for protection. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. The presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is. Wherever I am, God is. Namaste.